promoted. Good. More time to get better. Didn't get funded. Good. We own more of the company. Didn't get the job you wanted. Good. You can get more experience and build a better resume. You're gonna say good. You're gonna say good.
Kaijus, what's up? It's your boy Kaiju Kong, aka 2K, emerging from the depths of the soul to bring you some more Sigma. So sustenance. Alright guys, you'll immediately notice that today's weather is pretty gloomy, and I decided to leave the scenery and the lighting this way because this generates the ambiance for today's video topic, which is that you have to accept that life is hard, life is full of darkness, and life is full of suffering. And the sooner you come to terms and accept that as truth, the less likely you are to fold when times get tough. And you have to know that the more you grow as a man, the more that you develop and the more that you evolve, the more that you level up in life, the more life throws more difficult things your way, because you are prepared for it. It's like in a game. When you level up, the game gives you more challenging enemies. The game gives you more challenging levels to conquer. This opens up to talking about one of the key tenets of the Stoic philosophy, finding purpose in suffering, or finding a purpose to get through that suffering. Now, I'm going to give you a practical example from nature, which is the best teacher in the world. Many of you who follow my YouTube stories know that I plant a variety of plants to stay self-sufficient, one of which is garlic. Now, when I plant garlic, I usually take the best cloves that I can, and then I put them in a cup and I submerge them in around an inch of water, not totally drowning them, but around 3/4, covering most of the body of the cloves of garlic. The interesting thing is that of those 6 or 7 cloves of garlic that I planted in that cup, only one decided to grow and only one decided to shoot up a stem. Now, why is that? Because of all those cloves of garlic, only one knew its purpose, which was to grow into a full plant. The other garlic, when they saw that they were being submerged in water, they thought that they were drowning, they thought that they were dying, and thus they manifested what they were feeling on the inside, which was death. So they did die. Whereas that one knew, knowing that its purpose was to grow, and knowing that in order to grow it needed water, being submerged in water, it did not see that it was drowning. It saw that there was an abundance of the material it needed from which to grow. And then it did grow, because its internal aspect told it that that suffering was in fact the blessing. Now, the story doesn't end there. The other ones that died, I chucked them in the rubbish bin, whereas the one that grew, I took it and transplanted it into a pot of soil. Now it is covered up with soil, now it is in darkness, which is what many of you probably are feeling and experiencing today. You feel that you're stuck, you feel that you're in darkness. But do know that if you have a purpose to the suffering, if you have a purpose to what you're doing right now, you will know that this darkness that you feel, this experience and this suffering that you feel, these tough times are the raw materials and are actually the foundation from which you can draw the energy, draw the fuel, and draw the experience and knowledge and wisdom needed from which to then break forth and become an even stronger version of yourself. Because being submerged in water, drowning, will only take the plant so far. Being then transplanted into a pot of soil where it is in pure darkness, can it only then break free, if it decides to break free and then become a strong plant. When you have that very strong purpose in life and you have that strong why, you can conquer almost any how. The biggest challenge is to survive during the dark times and not allow yourself to identify yourself with the suffering, not to identify yourself with the darkness, but instead know and endure and keep your mind focused on who you will become as a result of this suffering. And when it is dark at night and you look up at the sky, it is not all darkness. You see little flickers of light. These are the stars, these are the planets. And the thing is, these planets, they are isolated. They are in solitude. But they know that they are planets, they know that they are stars, they do not identify themselves with what is majority, with what they see surrounding them, which is space, which is darkness. They know that they are planets, they know that they are stars, they do not associate themselves with what they see around them. And many of you, you are in the same spot. Whatever is majority around you does not mean that that is you. When everyone else or when everything around you is darkness, refuse to be the darkness. Instead, be the light. A planet is not the source of light itself. It is a reflector of the light. It is a reflector of a source of energy. Therefore, if those same stars and planets refuse to give off and refuse to reflect the light from the source, it is doing a disservice to both everyone else in the universe, and it is also doing a disservice to itself in terms of its purpose. So my main message in saying this is that some of you going through suffering, going through dark times, you may not see the fruits or the benefits firsthand, or you may not see it affecting you directly. But what you do not know is that what you are going through and the actions that you take and just being yourself, just enduring, you are actually giving light and you are acting as a guide to other people around you. And whether they thank you for it or not, that is beside the point. You are still acting as that guide in the dark, as that guide that leads them the way, that inspires them when they are feeling down. So consider that next time you think of giving up. Consider that next time you think that the road is too tough and that you're not giving anyone or you're not a benefit or you're not needed in the world, because you are. We all go through dark times. We all go through tough times. It is just a matter of finding the purpose as soon as you can in that suffering, knowing why you do things. And understanding that these challenges, these setbacks, every single thing, negative or positive, that happens to you is supposed to be a learning tool brought to you by the universe to evolve and develop as a person. The sooner you understand that, and the sooner you start acting based on that, the faster you can live a better life, having a better outlook on things, and actually saying yes to all the challenges that you are faced with. Remember, the most unfortunate man in the world is the man who has never faced adversity. The more adversity you face, the more opportunity the universe gives you to build stronger muscles, to build a stronger mental fortitude, to build a stronger discipline, to build a stronger everything. And these setbacks and these challenges are ways to prove, these are platforms for you to prove yourself to others and to yourself that you were made for greatness. And that's it, guys. If you like this message, do go ahead and leave a like and leave your comments down below. If you haven't already, do consider subscribing to the channel. This is the channel where we level up not only as lone wolves or tigers, but we are looking to become kaijus, the true Sigma male spirit animal. And with that, thank you very much for joining me, brothers. This is Kaiju Kong signing off. Take care.